They didn't get there quick enough in the whole half.
What would you like to see Virginia Tech do on the offensive end of the second half?
Well, I think they've got to get a spread. They've got to come up off the baseline. I think they're a little bit quicker, and they can do a better job on the baseline than they are.
Jarrell Eddie handling. Remember, Eddie with three fouls. We'll monitor that. He's their second leading scorer, a great shooter.
Always thought this was a big possession, John, in a close game. Start the second half and get the first basket.
Shot clock was winding down. Eddie couldn't hit, and the Mountaineers with the ball up six.
And they're doing a good screening job inside. Now they got a chance to go high-low.
Hines handling here, the sophomore from Mount Vernon. Shot clock under 10. Kalichla looking for help. Four in the shot clock. That's a two. And loose ball gathered in by Eddie. Good defensive rebounder.
That was a bad offensive possession to start the half with.
Brown wide open and one. And a chance at a three-point play.
Really quick. Yeah, and the reason he got that, again, is because he was off the baseline. We're going to see that he could have faked and gone either direction. There he just took straight to the bucket. We didn't get over. We, being West Virginia in that case, didn't get over to take away the drive. Slow offensive, or quick offensive movement, slow defensive help.
Yeah, that's an example of that quickness advantage you said Virginia Tech needs to use as Brown hits the free throw.
See, that's a huge offensive score, I think, for Virginia Tech. They've cut the lead in half already, and we're only a minute and a half into the game, and already they've cut it like that.
Hines the pull-up.
Push-off. Kalichli went a good move to get to the board and do the push off, which gives him another clock and another opportunity to score.
You get that foul on Sidarian Reigns, and that will be his second. Miles a three.
Take a little more time. They got the bucket, got the ball back, but take a little more time with your shot selection.
Miles feeding Murray, now the double team.
Very, very good help by the Hokies on that possession.
Hines couldn't hit, out of bounds. It'll stay with the Mountaineers.
This is a big point, I think. This is their third possession without changing ends. And if they can get a bucket here, it really helps. But if they don't, that's a lot to lose. Get set.
Wow, wide open in the corner. Eric Murray off the inbound.
Excellent, excellent look from out of bounds with the pass.
Green weaving through traffic and lays it in.
Well, that's one of the few times that we're going to see that they don't have really good help down at this end. They gave up the drive to the Hokies. And good call, definitely a foul.
Green's got 12 now after the three-point play.
I think that one thing Green has to do in this half, John, is be more aggressive going to the bucket, because they're going to send a second guy to help on him, which they have to do, and then he's got a chance to lay it off with some easy points. I think he spent most of the first half trying to score from outside.
Virginia Tech already with as many free throws in the second half as they had the entire first half. Two. Miles off the mark. Green pushing the pace into the lane. And good. 14 for Eric Green, the nation's second leading scorer.
Green was just much quicker and much more aggressive getting down the floor.
His only other scholarship offer out of high school was to James Madison. And now a senior and a chance to be first team all ACC this year.
Oh,
and there's Green, a steal. And there's that quickness. Virginia Tech leads by one.
See, Green was very unselfish. The Hokies got back to defend, but on that last bucket they got out in a hurry. That was maybe West Virginia's worst offensive play. Right there, the interception coming back. He brings the defensive man to him and has a great drop-off pass.
That last foul on Barksdale, his first.
These two free throws would have been big for West Virginia right here, getting back to the lead. Just tying it up here would be important. Nope. Oh, he did go. I thought that was a little bit too long. That was good for the Mountaineers.
Ends at 8-0 Virginia Tech run. Gary Brown on Green. The screen set by Reigns. Put back there by Barksdale.
Missed block out on that last basket. Now they're back in man-to-man.
Kevin Noreen back in for West Virginia. Had a huge first half.
See, the one thing I don't like about that shot is I don't like a guard to be dribbling the ball and then all of a sudden he shoots it. You know, get the ball moving. Make the defense move a little bit. Now he's hit two. Really great tip in there.
Henderson sneaks inside just 6'3", and he got in amongst the bigs and tipped it home. And an offensive foul, and that is Jarrell Eddy's fourth. Our under 16 timeout.
At the start of the second half.
Virginia Tech a perfect 7-0. We're tied at 36. And the Hokies now without Jarrell Eddy, their second leading scorer, just picked up his fourth foul.
Do a good job with that zone. Virginia Tech does. It slows the game down a little bit. They don't have to defend the drive as much when they're in the zone.
Brown blocked by Murray.
See, Brown, what Murray did a great job there. Upright, he didn't move into the ball. He let the ball come into him, and it took away what should have been a possession where they had a chance to score.
Noreen, another rebound, and it's out of bounds. It'll stay with West Virginia. So Jarrell Eddy sitting right now. Eddy averages 17 points a game. And he shoots 53% from three. Here's the offensive foul he picked up.
We're going to see some cross-screening right here. All right, good defense down on the baseline by the two big kids. They made him throw it back out.
Noreen, another rebound, and then he's bunked. Zadarian Reigns picks up the foul. And that's Reigns' third.
This has been a good offensive possession for West Virginia. They've drawn two fouls. They haven't scored yet. If they can get either a chance from the free throw line or get a bucket here, it may be their best possession of the game. Carelessness there.
Green off the mark and a pull-up. Oh, Gary Brown, the spin move, but he couldn't finish. And now Rankin back the other way. Brown, the lob. Oh! Green with a perfect pass, and Robert Brown throws it down.
That's the second time we've mentioned how much Green with the ball looks for people that are open.
And there's that quickness as well that you mentioned.
Don't want to turn around the game and just start shooting threes now like West Virginia has. They're getting behind.
Noreen, another rebound, his 11th.
Noreen saved a bucket right there. He stepped with inside with a good block out, and had he not moved, it would have been an easy bucket for the Hokies. By West Virginia in starting the second half, it wasn't as though they came out really hunting for bear like the Musketeer was the other day.
Now tell people what you're talking about.
The mascot, the WVU mascot that shot the bear with the mascot gun. A little.
The mascot with the musket. Green steps through, and he'll shoot two.
Green makes a great move. If we could see that quickly, we're going to see Green make a move with his hips that shakes the defensive man up. And because of doing that, he's on the line shooting two. Right here. Watch this little move he makes when he gets into the lane. Right there. He slowed it up just a little bit. He forced the defensive man out of the play, and when he moved, it resulted in a two-shot foul.
Well, we got three ranked teams to end with, four teams in the top 13, three in the top 10. And Eric Green with that make, and he's got 16.
When you've got a guy like Green that scores not just because he's a shooter, he scores because he drives, he runs, and he also shoots. He's going to shoot a lot of free throws, and they've got to be careful of that here as they try to get back in the ball game.
Toki's been much more efficient. Points per possession, a good measuring stick of how efficient an offense is, and the Hokies have been one of the best in the country, top five in that department coming into this game.
The guy with the ball is always at a little bit of an advantage in driving if he gives a little fake, first of all, because that sets the defensive man a little bit off the path he should be in and allows the driver to draw the foul because they're not in a head-on-head situation, just like that.
Staten gets fouled. And that one is going to be on Eric Green.
Good drive, and was able to get a little bit of a head start, and the defensive man came right into him with the body.
Foul line for the Mountaineers. That last foul. 3-1 Staten. Two shots.
Staten gets the first. Juwan Staten averaging about 11 a game. West Virginia had a big lead in the first half, led by as many as 10. Beg your pardon, by as many as a dozen.
Well, they're doing a good job right now of staying in the game. It looked almost like, or there was an opportunity for Virginia Tech to get a little distance in this game. And the Mountaineers have been very good at getting back into a tighter game.
Wood can't hit. That one rebounded by Henderson. Mountaineers a chance to tie or take the lead. Brown into traffic, in and out. Rebound Henderson. His shot partially blocked. And another block there. Here comes Brown and Green. Oh, good feed, and Wood is fouled. He'll shoot two. Green going behind the back. Aaron Harris charged with that last foul.
Not so sure there that Green shouldn't have just gone right to the bucket. That they were lucky that West Virginia fouled them, because that was giving up a pretty good opportunity to score. Right there, just go right to the bucket with it. He actually had a better pass than that, too.
Now, a spot like that, is there ever a place for the behind-the-back pass for you?
Not there, there wasn't.
Okay.
You know, because he really had to throw it through a defensive player where there was another defensive player, and they were lucky to come out of it with a foul. If you're coming down in a situation where you've got, like, three against one or three against two, if you can move the ball a little bit to one side and then make a clever pass, a bounce pass or behind-the-back pass, but there, that's not a situation where West Virginia should have committed a foul.
Did Bob Knight ever make a behind-the-back pass in college?
I don't think so.
Hokies by four as we close in on 12 to go here second half. Murray.
When I played in college, John, when I was in the game, I just looked for where Lucas was.
Murray, a corner three.
They're beating him down the floor.
Man, that almost went in. He wanted a foul called. Didn't happen. Kevin Noreen. A double-double for the sophomore from Minnesota. What an afternoon he's having.
I think Barksdale just fell asleep there. That was the third shot Noreen has hit, and Barksdale had all the time in the world to get there. Well, that's a big miscue on his part.
Brown, good feed. Reigns throws it down. And the Hokies by three will correct that. Noreen with 9 points and 11 rebounds.
I think Barksdale wanted to imitate the Statue of Liberty there.
They get a foul underneath. Virginia Tech, James Johnson's team, trying to improve. This is in the early season, a perfect 7-0 coming off a win at home over number 15 Oklahoma State. And here the sophomore from Puerto Rico, Gary Brown at the line.
Now this is important. I mean, it's a dumb thing to say, but they just can't let them get too far away. And you've got those free throws. You got to try to make sure you're set, and you got to make them, because all of a sudden Virginia Tech could be 9-10 points ahead.
Green trying to turn the corner, uses the glass. He has 18. And he's putting on a pretty good display, showing why he is second in the country in scoring.
See, you mentioned a while ago, John, but right now, since they were down by 10, Virginia Tech has picked up 15 points on West Virginia. It's been all them after going down by 10.
Gary Brown able to hit a three. And it's a two-point game.
Huge basket. It's hard to say with 10 minutes left, but that was a huge, huge basket for West Virginia. Now he's going to score here.
As you were saying, Sedarian Reigns with the bucket, back to a four-point lead.
The reason I said that is because that help side had not moved to take away that move to his right shoulder. He had a little room, and he made a little fake to his left shoulder and moved to his right shoulder.
Kevin Noreen, what a game he is having. He's been monstrous off the bench. A dozen points, 11 rebounds is a career high. Wandering through traffic, he's fouled on the floor.
That's a situation, John, where the defense has to close the driving route. As the ball is being moved in that direction, it was going left, the defensive man further to the driver's left has got to close that lane, so there isn't even an opportunity to go toward the bucket, because that's where the vast majority of fouls are created, the defense versus the offense, in half-court play on the drive. The great thing about the drive is you have three chances. Make a good pass, get to the bucket and score, or get to the foul line.
Round now with 13. Feed into Kalichlu, who's been quiet, goes left-handed, but it's tipped out of there. Green pushing ahead, able to split the defense and throw it down.
With this lineup they have in the game right now, Virginia Tech is a much quicker team. They do a good job with their zone. Now they got into Noreen. That's where Kalichi's got to look to score. He's got to make a little foot fake and go to the bucket with it when he had it in there.
Keaton Miles, big three there. And back to a two-point game. Hokies only two threes, and despite that, they lead. Brown a little out of control, and they get a foul on Noreen. I beg your pardon. Nope, just out of bounds, Virginia Tech basketball. And again, for Virginia Tech, they're up two. And one of their top players, Jarrell Eddy, is on the bench with four fouls. And there's Eddie with a towel draped around his head.
Green is trying and doing a pretty good job of it, being cautious, taking his time. not been in a hurry, knowing they've got a little bit of a lead, take their time, use up some of that time. The more they use up and get good shots, the fewer minutes that West Virginia is going to have the ball.
Green missed everything there, and now West Virginia can tie or take the lead.
Well, they've got to take their time. They've got to be sure they get it. And a shot at Kelechi there. He's not moving much inside. He's got to do a better job of turning inside.
Oh, and Aaron Harris buries a three. West Virginia back on top by one. Sixth lead change in the game. Brown looking for some space. Little floater inside, and that'll roll home. Robert Brown with 15. He averages a little over 13. Harris inside, and they get a block. That'll be Sidarian Raines charged with that foul.
Good drive, but Raines was just a little slow in recognizing the drive. Important thing in helping out against a driver is that you recognize the drive. He put his hand or arm around my shoulders as we're walking upstairs, and he said, "Son, for what it's worth, you and prayer are not a good mix." That was our last pregame prayer.
Now, back in those days, were you nervous as a young coach?
Well, I was nervous as an old coach. You know, I think if you're not a little bit nervous, you shouldn't be in the business, because you know you've got always got five kids in short pants with your paycheck in their mouth out there, and you got to be being a little bit nervous makes you pretty active too.
Mountaineers by a point. Marquise Rankin into the lane. That one in and out. And the rebound pulled down by Staten, pushing up ahead, and then he'll slow it down and wait for numbers.
Staten did a great job there, because this should have been a great opportunity, and had he tried to force it, they don't get that three out of it.
Aaron Harris.
Really a good job by Staten.
Aaron Harris has hit some big threes here in the second half. The freshman from Indianapolis. Really good job by Staten to show some patience and then get his teammate involved.
He didn't force it. He picked it up. We'll see. Picked it up here way beyond the top of the key. Backs up from here. Now he's got a chance to look things over, and he sees the open man. And the thing about that was so good was the open man was set to take that shot. Harris was set to take that shot. Had his feet in gear. He was leaning into the ball. It was a great move by him taking the shot.
Aaron Harris with 10 points, 8 since the break. I want to go back to Virginia Tech for a second. You got Raines with 4, Eddie with 4. There's 6:24 to go in the game. How long does James Johnson wait to bring those guys back?
Well, I think you play with caution. You don't make sure you don't create an offensive foul. You move your feet. I think you just want to ride with them. You know, they're smart kids. They know what's at stake here at the end of the game. They've got a little over 6 minutes to play.
A little bit of token pressure there from West Virginia. An 11-2 run for the Mountaineers, and they push to a 4-point lead.
Not a good possession there at all. I would want to have always some presence inside in the lane, higher up on the lane, not down on the baseline, but 8 feet up on the lane. So we've got an outside opportunity and an inside opportunity. And Noreen had a bad angle on that pass. He had to take a step over where he was throwing it on an angle into the post rather than try to throw it straight down where the postman couldn't quite get to it.
Jarrell Eddy coming back into the game. You want him to get closer to the sideline, take a step.
Well, improve the angle. You can't throw that head on. You can't throw it straight down. If you get out on an angle, you can make a much better pass into the post. Now, Virginia Tech has taken its time. They've got plenty of time yet, but they don't want to put themselves in a position where they have to do something bad. All right, now they got to be going.
Green, the pull-up.
Again, I don't like the dribble like that so long, Johnny. If you got the ball moving around, the defense has to look at different things. Want to reverse the ball? Try the other side. Now come down in. Get it on top. Look what you got. Don't put it down in that corner. How to rule. There's your boy. There's a good shot.
Oh, it bounced right into Keaton Miles' hands. They get a fresh 35.
Noreen may be just a little bit tired right now. That looked like a tired shooter. Don't have to be in any kind of a hurry till they get down to 15 seconds. Make the defense really play for 15, 20 seconds.
Yeah, they get a foul in there by Harris as he hacked Reigns. That'll be foul number 6 on West Virginia. 18 fouls on Virginia Tech. And the foul on Harris is his 2nd. Bob Huggins a little frustrated with Dennis Caliccio. I can only assume the choice of shot there.
Well, no question about it, but he hasn't moved real well inside in the course of this game with utilizing the strength that he has.
Reigns going to work, looking for some space, couple of ball fakes, wouldn't go, and Reigns comes away with it. And then the feed off the legs for unbeaten Virginia Tech.
Good move right there, getting the ball out of trouble.
Good great. Look, Green finds Reigns.
Great feed. As soon as Green caught the ball, he knew where Reigns was. It didn't stay in his hand more than a second.
So a 2-point game here. Well, they had Murray wide open for an easy layup.
I don't know what happened with Reigns slipped somehow and went into the backboard.
Both teams will be shooting 1-1.
West Virginia's into a zone now. They're going to try and keep them from driving.
Green with a huge three. He's got 23. And Virginia Tech within a point. Only the 3rd three of the game. 3 for 16 for the Hokies from beyond the arc. A team that normally shoots 40% from the 3-point line.
Good cut right there.
Murray again banks it home. Their last 2 buckets for Eric Murray.
Really good cut by Murray. Now they did a good job of taking the shot away from Green, but they didn't recover to the other side. Think about here is the shot fake. When they've got the ball at their end. West Virginia wants to take time, not be in a hurry, try and get it set where they have both a drive and a chance to score. Now get the big guy inside. Get Murray inside where he can be open.
They get a foul inside, and that's going to be on Marquise Rankin. James Johnson going offense, defense, as Eddie and Reigns for that defensive possession were on the bench. They get set to check back in, each of them with 4 fouls.
I'll tell you, Staten did a great job there, John. He didn't come back where he got the ball from. He saw a little bit of a crack. He got in there, made some movement, drew the foul right there. This was a very, very big play, I think, for West Virginia that Staten just made. Still, it's still, whether he makes or misses this one, Virginia Tech has still got the score to go ahead. Been a little better off if you made both of them. Green has to be careful here that he doesn't try and win the game by himself. He just can't.
Barksdale wide open. C.J. Barksdale not expecting that one as he's able to bury that.
Well, Green spotted him, and that's he did just what I said he had to do. He can't get too quick. But gosh, he did a great job there with that pass. That's as good a pass as you're ever going to see in a game because he could have wound up taking a poor shot. What a big pass that was.
Almost came up with a steal there, did Green. Miles. Oh, that was halfway down. And it's Hokies basketball. 1:25 to go. Bob Huggins' team down by a point.
Now, the thing that West Virginia's got to try and do is, and it's gonna, they're going to use some time up. They're not going to get the ball back, but they don't want to foul here. They don't want to create a foul. They want to make them work all the way down.
Reigns backing down, goes left hand, in and out. Tip won't go. And Murray the board.
Well, don't be in a hurry like that.
Noreen, the offensive rebound, and the putback. Kevin Noreen.
Boy, that went from the worst shot taken in the game to a tremendous play by Noreen.
Aaron Harris a little aggressive. Noreen, what a game. Green spinning. Reigns the rebound. And he's fouled.
This is just a great play by Maureen here. I think it was a bad shot to take. He may have even drawn a foul with that, but he made a great move going into the defensive man and getting that bucket.
First career double-double for Maureen, 14 points, 12 boards. And you see Reigns at 69%.
Now, if he misses this one, West Virginia can get down without even scoring, and there will only be 12 seconds left in the game. So what will happen if he misses this, they will draw a foul, and they're going to have to make free throws down there. But it does, even if he makes it, they still have to work to get to the free throw line.
Murray able to corral it. And then Brown is charged with the foul as he tried to strip it away from Eric Murray. And they'll march down the other end where Murray will shoot.
He does a good job just getting the basketball. Really good job. Can't foul him under those circumstances. Now, if Murray scores, they've got to come back. They being Virginia Tech, they've got to come back and look to score quickly so they have another scoring opportunity. If he scores and they go real slow, then they might not get another scoring opportunity. They're still going to come out of this with a lead no matter what.
West Virginia 9-for-17 from the line today.
See, good free throw shooting would have the game over with by now. That's why it's so important. Kids never realize that two from the line is far more important than two from the floor because of all that it rolls around.
2-point game and a timeout.
So you can drive the baseline. What they want is for Green to have a chance to drive. Noreen did a great job there.
Green looks for help. Now Brown. Oh, my goodness.
He
banked it in. And they have the lead. That is the old no.
You've got to be able to drive baseline here. He's going to go right to the bucket.
Right there. Shot blocked. And it'll stay with West Virginia. 9 to go in the game.
All right. That was a good move. They had a chance. He had a chance to draw the foul. Get deeper. Get off the foul line. Don't be so tight down there. Give yourselves room.
Gary Brown to inbound. Trying to find some help. Eventually finds Staten. Little shake and bake. Staten right at the rim, and he lays it in. West Virginia by a point. Here's Green.
Don't foul him.
And no, they get
a cut to the bucket, and they have to throw the ball into the backcourt here.
They move Noreen back. You'd assume they will try their best to find Eric Green. 3.4 to go, and the Hokies down a point. Here's Green. Green for the win. West Virginia wins it. Bob Huggins' team knocks off unbeaten Virginia Tech. In the end, the basketball in the Hokies' best player's hands, and not quite able to knock it down. Green finishes with 23. And the Mountaineers pick up a one-point win.
All right, here, I really think that Green should have gone to the bucket here. He's got a chance to go to the bucket. Yep. Had a good shot, but there was no thought of the foul there. When you get down to the end, whatever it is that you do, you've got to be able to draw the foul as well as get the shot.
Big win for Bob Huggins in West Virginia. 68-67, they beat Virginia Tech. For Bob Knight and our entire crew, I'm John Chami. The preceding has been an exclusive presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Now we send it to Madison, Wisconsin, Dave O'Brien and Dan Dockage.